And nothing dark can be exist in the face of the light. And when that light comes from the divine, comes from the source, comes from God, whatever you want to call it, well, I think that's what we're here for. I think it's a form of soul purification. That's what I think is going on. We're here to change reality into something better. And it's all a reflection of ourselves. And if you know yourself, nothing else has to happen. That's it. That's the way out. That's exactly the answer. There was a great story that was recently sent to me by someone, which I'd like to actually read you if I could. It's just a short. It says, Are you a carrot, an egg, or a coffee bean? A young woman went to her mother and told her about life and how things were so hard for her. She didn't know how she was going to make it through and wanted to give up. She was tired of fighting and struggling. It seemed as one problem was solved, a new one arose. Her mother took her to the kitchen. She filled three pots with water. In the first, she placed carrots. In the second, she placed eggs. And in the last, she placed ground coffee beans. She let them sit and boil without saying a word. In about 20 minutes, she turned off the burners and she fished the carrots out and placed them in a bowl. She pulled the eggs out and placed them in a bowl. She ladled the coffee into a bowl. Turning to her daughter, she said, "Tell me what you see." "Carrots, eggs, and coffee," she replied. She brought her closer and asked her to feel the carrots, and she did and noted they were soft. Then she asked her to take an egg and break it. After pulling off the shell, she observed a hard-boiled egg. Finally, she asked her to sip the coffee. The daughter smiled as she tasted its aroma, and she said, "What's the point, mother?" Her mother explained to her that each of these objects had faced the same adversity, boiling water, but each reacted differently. The carrot went in strong, hard, and unrelenting. However, after being subject to the boiling water, it softened and became weak. The egg had been fragile. Its thin outer shell had protected its liquid interior. But after being through the boiling water, its inside became hardened. The coffee beans were unique, however. After they were in the boiling water, they had changed the water. "Which are you?" she asked her daughter. "When adversity knocks on your door, how do you respond? Are you a carrot, an egg, or a coffee bean? Am I the carrot that seems strong, but with pain or adversity, do I wilt and become soft and lose my strength? Am I the egg that starts with a malleable heart, but changes with the heat? Did I have a fluid spirit, but after death, a breakup, a financial hardship, or some other trial, have I become hardened and stiff? Does my shell look the same on the outside, but on the inside, I am bitter and tough, with a stiff spirit and a hardened heart? Or am I the coffee? The bean actually changes the hot water, the very circumstances that brings the pain. When the water gets hot, it releases its fragrance and flavor. If you are like the bean, when things are at their worst, you get better and change the situation around you." You know, so I think they disconnect us from reality by disconnecting us from our own biology. And I think it's a methodical thing. And whether it was done years ago, I mean, whether we come back and do this all the time, we're just caught in this endless loop. I mean, when you look at deja vu, perhaps that's what deja vu is. Perhaps you have these experiences because you actually have done this before.
Yeah.
And you always get to that point. You're always given the decision. You can always find a way out. Every time you come here, you can find a way out. You've just got to move yourself out of that fear and be prepared to stand in your soul power. That's the key out. You can almost think of this as a form of soul purification. After you've come back here enough times, perhaps you get to that point where you are prepared to face infinity without flinching. And I think that is the trick. When the hours are the darkest and the trials are at their greatest, do you elevate to another level? How do you handle adversity? Are you a carrot, an egg, or a coffee bean? And that's what all this is about. You can really bring out the best in yourself when faced with the most adversity. That's when you really discover your own strength, if you can approach things in the right way and look at them with the right eyes. As I often say, you know, no stake in the outcome. Face infinity without flinching. And don't step outside your moral compass for anything. If people simply did that and were aware of their personal power to do that, we could literally change the world in a day. We wouldn't need any external sources to do it for us.
I could see it all when I was a kid. I thought this is, I got kicked out of four high schools back when I was 16 years old because I was arguing with my teachers saying that, yeah, everything you're teaching us is leading us into this dystopia. You're teaching me to be a little cog in the big machine. You're basically removing me of my life skills, and that's not what I come to school for. I thought I was going to come here to get taught about life and get taught life skills and how to be a better human being, you know. So I was having these arguments when I was a kid. So Yeah, I mean, you can kind of see it coming. You don't want it to be true, but you can see it coming, and so you feel a need to warn people. As soon as we're born, we're programmed into all this stuff by our parents. We're fed all this food, which shuts us down. You know, most people's pineal gland is calcified by the time they're 8 years old. But when they're young, they're kids, they're seeing fairies in the garden and all sorts of magical stuff.
And face infinity without flinching, the knack of being able to face with serenity odds that are not included in your calculations or expectations. You know, the whole quest for knowledge that we're on all the time. Everything that you need to know is within you. The whole quest for knowledge, the quest for information, the biting of the apple. What do you think they put a bit apple on the computer, on the Apple computer? They're showing you, they're leading you in there, your quest for knowledge. You couldn't just sit under the tree and enjoy the shade of the tree. You wanted to cut the tree down and measure the rings to find out how old it was. Now you don't have the tree to enjoy. You wanted to pull the rocks to pieces to find out what they're made of. You started to tear the earth apart. You tore your garden to pieces to find out what it was made of. Why do you need that information? You want to examine the stars to find out what they're... You can't go there. You can't examine. You can't ever get to space or the stars. Why don't you just enjoy the beauty of what God gave you rather than trying to find out about it? Because you want all this information, and your quest for knowledge causes you to leave the path of wisdom. You don't tear a kitten to pieces in order to love it. The minute you started tearing the earth apart to find out how it works, you left the path of wisdom and you led yourself directly into the mainframe the way you're doing now. Because it's all the answers are within you. You don't need to know all that stuff. If you really look within you, you already know, which is why you're looking down these rabbit holes, just for confirmation of what you already know, but you don't believe yourself. You need someone else to tell you, you know? I need outside confirmation for what I feel inside that I already know. Why do you need to get this confirmation from your peers so that you'll fit in with them, you know? No, that's not what it's about. It's about you. It's about your experience here and what you do with it. And are you prepared to have no stake in the outcome of this? Because this is just, you're only here for a breath.
You're getting through life. Be aware of who and what you are, that all you're dealing with is other people, just other forms of consciousness that are completely much the same as you. You all have equal value. You may not have equal talents or equal experience or, you know, equal attributes, but you all have equal value as a form of consciousness. And perhaps you get to that point where you finally reach that clarity, and you can face infinity without flinching, and then you move on to the next point. So maybe it's something like that.
So, you know, there's so much more to this than what people are seeing on the surface, and it's about your experience and what you do with it. I mean, I really don't know how else to say it. You know?
This is a big test anyway. I have no fear of death. And in many ways, it just vindicates what I've said. And it's inspiring for people to see that. And it inspires them to actually listen and actually put things into action in their own lives. And I still get emails from people saying, well, I've just changed the way I approach the world and my whole life has changed and, you know, everything's great now. With all this stuff that's coming, I mean, I have no problem with any of this. It's terribly dystopian what's coming. I find it all inspiring.
Believe in yourself. Face infinity without flinching, because that is your ticket out of here. Ticket out of this realm. It's a ticket to return to God, is to be able to face infinity without flinching, put love in your heart, realize there is only one law to creation, that is unconditional love and service to creation, which isn't service to self. It isn't service to others at the expense of the self. It isn't service to self at the expense of others. It isn't service to the earth at the expense of the people. It isn't service to the people at the expense of the earth. It's unconditional love for all. And if you can't love yourself, you never ever be able to love anything else. And the only way you can really love yourself is to discover your true power. Just believe in yourself and know that all the answers you seek are in there. All you have to do is believe in yourself. You don't need justification from your peers. It's all there in your heart. Just step into your heart and you'll change the world.